In my most recent video, I shared with you how you can use Semrush along with ChatGPT to create cool calculator websites that generate traffic and are able to be monetized by you. And so in today's video, I'm going to be sharing an extension of that idea by sharing with you how you can take some of the data insights from Semrush and pair them with ChatGPT in order to come up with new opportunities or content strategies for an existing website of yours. So in order to accomplish this task today, we're going to continue building on the example of that website we found in my last video, which was called sportcalculators.com. We found that sportcalculators.com over the years has been around for almost a decade, and it has thousands of visits every single month, in fact. And so what's really cool about this is it just goes to show you that there's pretty much a website for anything. As long as you create it, people will eventually come, as long as you stick around to that idea long enough. And so here you can see that sportcalculators.com currently has the number two placement for bowl score calculator, but it also has some top placements like bowling handicap calculator, pace bike calculator. And what we also saw was that when we disabled our ad blocker, there also were more than enough ads for us to take a look at that. So what we know is that this site is doing pretty well. We could probably use ChatGPT to create some calculators if we wanted about this. But the other thing we can do is we can start to look at what might their strategy be in terms of content, aside from, you know, just in general, the calculators themselves. So in order to do this, what we can do is we can first take a look at what are some competing sites of, you know, sportcalculators.com. Well, you can see that another one is Bowling Genius, another one's Bike Calculator. So what I usually like to do is I like to click through this competitive positioning map, and I'll make sure I can scroll down far enough so that you can see it. But what I can do from here is I can go ahead and take a look at what are some of the things that the competitors of the site are doing. Well, there's one called bikecalculator.com. And here you can see Semrush is saying, okay, over time, you know, this site has had a variety of different traffic stories along the way, but what it's really doing well is bike calculator, cycling calculator, and things like that. So if I go ahead and open this up, now you can see this is the bike calculator. It also has an Apple app, and it just goes over how to use this, and it's a very simple calculator, nothing too crazy here. But what you can see is that it's a very similar concept, right? There's an input, returns an output. It's really great in terms of interactivity. And if I go to the about section, it's probably just created by, you know, yep, a cyclist, somebody who cares about this problem a lot. And what I can do from here is once I start to get an idea of a couple of these different, you know, concepts, I can keep on going into the competitor section here, and I'll start to get a sense of what the different sites are. So bikecalculator.com was one of them. The other one was sportcalculators.com. I'm going to go into ChatGPT now and go into browse with Bing. And I'm going to say, you are an SEO specialist tasked with the need to come up with 10 content ideas to build out the topical authority of your website. Your website competes with bikecalculator.com and sport calculator. It's a plural, sportcalculators.com, and you want to draw inspiration from these two sites. Please first review the two competitors and summarize their content strategy, then output your top 10 content ideas in a table, including different factors of consideration, such as keywords to target, potential traffic, and an overall description of the content you'd place on the page. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at what ChatGPT does here. Okay, so here you can see ChatGPT is giving me some results based on the information gathered. Here's a summary of the content strategies. Bikecalculator.com provides bicycle performance prediction calculator, allows for people to compute speed, power, more important parameters such as weight, grade, position, and tire type. Tool seems very comprehensive, taking all these considerations. Sportcalculators.com offers a broad array of calculators related to different sports, including cycling, running, bowling, and triathlons. Their strategy appears to be more general, catering to a wide audience. That's exactly what I would have said looking at both here. And now you can start to see here are 10 content ideas to help you build out the topical authority of your site. Cycling power calculator, bike gear ratio calculator, calorie burn calculator for cycling, cycling training generator, bike maintenance plan, etc. So it's really starting to lean in this idea of, you know, what it's finding as the pattern is between both sites. The cycling ideas were definitely more interesting here. And so here you can start to see that this is some of the content that comes up. And then what I can start to do is, great, thanks for those suggestions. Now please come up with specific long form content ideas that could be interesting to interlink to each of these 10 earlier ideas. Here's some long tail ideas that can be interlinked. So the original idea is cycling power calculator. Now the long form idea is the science of cycling, understanding power and performance, the ultimate guide to bike gear, how to optimize your ride, burning calories with cycling, comprehensive look at energy expenditure. Awesome. So these are the sorts of things where I can then start to think about, okay, you know, now act like an SEO specialist with decades of experience. Please output a list of long tail keywords from your long form content ideas with estimates for the monthly traffic of each phrase. All right, so the reason why I'm doing this is because I wanna take the idea that ChatGPT has given me and feed it back in the other direction to then come up with some different ideas for, you know, long tail phrases. Then I'm gonna take those results and feed it back into Semrush to then validate whether or not any of these ideas are potentially interesting for me. Okay, so now it's gone ahead and finished browsing and now it's coming up with some ideas here. They can't really do the monthly estimates, that's fine, just because in general, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna feed it back into Semrush anyways. But here you can see, here are some ideas here. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a look here and I might actually refine this a little bit further. Instead of this prompt, which doesn't seem to be giving me all that much great content back, what I'm gonna do is let's look at this idea. What would be some potential long tail keyword phrases to explore to generate organic traffic? So in other words, I'm re-prompting ChatGPT to consider this particular idea and see if there are particular phrases that might be interesting for this particular phrase on the science of cycling and whatnot. All right, so in this particular example, what you can see is that it didn't really do all that much in terms of the browsing results. However, it did give me some suggestions. So what I can do here is I can go ahead and copy these in, and I'll probably just go ahead and look for things like cycling power or cycling performance. So what I might do is I'm actually go into the keyword research tool afterwards, but I'll do cycling power, cycling performance, probably do role science of cycling power. I can just go ahead and search this for now. And now you can start to see some of the different phrases that return. All right, so here what I can do is I can take that phrase, cycling power, and now I can do what I did in a couple videos ago from here, which was I went ahead and filtered down by 40 or less, keyword difficulty, volume of at least, generally speaking, I like to do 100 or more. And then I also like to look for word counts of 3 or more. And here you can start to see some different phrases that are coming in. I'm seeing a lot of cases where it's only like 3 words exactly or so, but there are some other phrases. So here you can see power cycle. That's not necessarily what I really want. So that's less related to bikes. So I'm starting to really worry in this particular case of if cycling power is actually the right phrase. Specifically, what I might want to do is I might want to think about power on cycling performance. So let's try cycling performance. So I'm going to apply that same search. All right. So what I can start to see is that there's a lot of just general phrases around cycle performance. So I don't actually think this is that interesting. So this is a good example of sometimes you need to work through the long tail phrase to see exactly what the sort of intent is. But here you can see now I can go into bike gears. So let's go into bike gears, guide maybe. See what it comes up with there. No? Bike gears. All right, now we're starting to cook. So here you can see bike gear ratio, gears for a mountain bike, bike gear shifter, mountain bike with gears. So this is now where we start to come up with some ideas. So what I'm gonna do is I'm probably going to go for informational keywords next. So now I'm down to 47 and I'm gonna go ahead and export this and I'm gonna feed it back into ChatGPT. Okay, so I got this here. I'm gonna go ahead and copy this, save that. You are a data analyst and SEO specialist. You're given this data set from Semrush. Please come up with 10 long form content ideas that are interesting based off of considerations for keyword, difficulty, volume, and number of results. Output your ideas in the form of a table. And I'm just gonna go ahead and paste that in there. And once I've done so, I'm gonna start to have some different thoughts. I'm actually gonna go ahead and have this in a new window. That way I don't have to browse. I don't have to browse the web. So I'm gonna actually just reset this. All right, so I just went ahead and set this back to default instead of browse with Bing beta. And now I'm just gonna paste this in. All right, so I specifically want a table. So I need to make this more clear because it's not giving me that table. I'm gonna say make sure to output your ideas in the form of a table. Let's try that again. Okay, so it's starting to analyze this, and what you can see is that we have topics on bike gear ratios, gear shifting problems, keywords. What's it's not doing though is I wanted to return it in the form of a table, so I might have to prompt this again. So I might say, now that you understand the data, please come up with 10 long form content ideas in a table format with a description of what you'd cover in the article idea. All right, so here you can see now it's starting to come up with ideas, but this is not related. So use the data set from above for bike gears. Let's try that again. All right, so here you can see it's starting to come up with content ideas, comes up with a description as well. And there you have it. So this is just going to keep on spitting out different content ideas. From here, I can start to prompt ChatGPT for different content outlines as well as thoughts based off of this. But what I did was I started with something where I had a general sense of what was going on in a particular competitor's website, got a sense of what was working for them, went into the keyword overview tool, and then switched to the keyword magic tool to then start to analyze exactly what are some opportunities. And then I started asking ChatGPT to come up with some long form ideas, because what I do is I would then create content to link back to the calculator that I'd build with the help of ChatGPT. So that's pretty much it in terms of this video. What I just wanted to show you is how you can leverage a variety of different tools in order to get to the same output or a key output that you need. What you need to do though is you need to think about what is one tool good for versus the other. And from there, you'll be able to figure out different creative ways to leverage both. In the case where you haven't already tried Semrush, feel free to check out my trial link in the video description below. And if you have any questions, feel free to let me know in the comments below.